Rudy weer eens vanaf die Momentum Rapport Tour. En dit is gisteren een baie interessante individuele tijdtoets wat in Beaufort West beslis is waarna ons kyk. Francie Kreer was die draer van die Momentum geel trui en hy het alles in die strijd gewerp om hom te behou. Maar Willie Engelbrecht, die man wat verlede jaar die tour gewen het, het ook sy eie idees gehad en op die ou en 20 sekondes achter die wenner Andrew McLean geëindig. En gepraat van Andrew McLean, hier is hy. In die Hansom fietstoer het ons gesien dat hy 3 minute uit Willie Engelbrecht uitgehaal het tijdens die laaste skop. Robbie McIntosh, die kaptein van die topsport VW Fox span, tijdens hierdie skof nummer 3, daar die individuele tyd toe, hy jag baie goed, en hy het op die ouwe vierde geëindig, een man wat reeds die rapport toer 4 keer gewen het. Hier kry hy die geel trui. Niemand het in die stadium gedink dat hy hem dalk kan afstaan nie, maar dinge het so 'n bietjie verander later in die aand. Dit was die posisie gewees, maar reeds gisteravond in Beaufort West het ons bespiegelinge gehoor dat daar van die beamtes was wat een ander besluit geneem het en die besluit was dat Francie Kreer die geel trui sou bou. Ons is nie in kennis gestel nie, maar hier by die wegspring nou in Maikiesfontein is dit amptelik dat Francie Kreer die geel trui behou, alhoewel hy en Robbie McIntosh dieselfde tyd het op die oomblik, is dit Francie Kreer wat die geel trui behou. Kom ons praat met Johnny Hoorn, een van die spanbestuurders van Topsport Volkswagen Fox. Johnny, what do you feel about this decision?
Actually, I think that the decision itself is actually a very good one because Francie was wearing the yellow jersey. I think he should keep it. But I just think that the officials, before they start making announcements and doing things that they do, they should rather actually get everything written out properly before we and everybody else gets the proper results tests long before the decision is actually made. Everybody seems to be jumping to conclusions all the time and nobody really knows what's going on after.
What would you prefer at this stage, to have the jersey or not?
I think it's better that the jersey goes to Francie because he deserves to keep it.
Thank you, Johnny Hoorn. En saam met ons, een van die welbekende figure, Alan van Heerden, kaptein van die Snowflake Blue Ribbon Span. Alan, your feelings about the jersey and the change that happened?
Well, obviously I'm very disappointed because I feel that our sponsor lost a lot of publicity last night through this incident. But I don't blame the officials, you know. Anyone can make a mistake. It's one of those unfortunate mistakes. But what I do object to, that we were only told late last night by the press about it. I think we should have been told last night that we're keeping the yellow jersey, and at least Francie, you know, his morale would have been a lot better. But losing it with such a small margin and then coming back to us and telling us we've got the yellow jersey again, it's a bit unfortunate. But as I say, the most important thing is that our sponsor lost a lot of publicity last night, and that's the reason why we're upset.
Okay, now you've got the jersey, and what are you going to do?
Well, obviously, we're going to keep it. We're going to keep it right through to the end. I think a lot of people underestimated Francie Kruger in this too. I think a lot of people were saying that Willie and Andrew McLean are the favourites, but I think they've got another contender on this tour, and I think Francie's going to show them a lot right through to the end.
Die stem van Alan van Heerden, en hier in die skilderachtige Maikiesfontein gee dit vir ons geleentheid om 'n bietjie meer inligting by Dix Foster te kry.
The small settlement of Maikiesfontein was established in the dry Karoo air in 1883 by a young Scotsman named James Douglas Logan. He was a man who suffered from a lung complaint, and he opened this as a resort for other people who also suffered from the same. Cecil John Rhodes was also a man who stayed in the Hotel Milner, which is probably the major landmark in Maikiesfontein today. The London lampposts, which were imported by Logan, still line its main street. The entire town was sold in 1968 to a hotelier who transformed this place into a tourist attraction. And the little church behind the hotel, which was then known as the Kirk, is still in use today as a traveller's chapel. During the Second Anglo-Boer War, the Hotel Milner was transformed into a military hospital, and the turret on top of the hotel was used as a lookout post for the troops. And it is from this historic little town, Maikiesfontein, where the riders will soon set off on the fourth stage of the Momentum Rapport Cycle Tour.
Dis die begin van skof nummer 4. 137 kilometer lever hierdie meer as 70 jaar spoor. Dis van Maikiesfontein oor die Tronspas en tot op die ou end waar hulle gaan eindig in Tulbag. En twee bobas van die berge premies wat gaan voorlê.
The stage sets off in cool conditions, but the earlier rain seems to be a thing of the past. The first 40 kilometers saw the usual early morning attacks taking place. At about 45 kilometers from the start, the real racing started in earnest with the series of attacks that followed. Everybody had a go. This took the riders into Toews River to contest two hotspots, the first one going to Francie Kruger and the second one being won by Willy Engelbrecht. This means that the skins competition in the hotspots is a carryover for tomorrow, with a lump sum of about 520 rand for the first hotspot winner. At 66 kilometers, the bunch turned right, bringing about a series of attacks in the extremely dangerous crosswind conditions. Lauren Smith and Stephen Wallet of Mnet Southern Suns had a go, but they were soon overhauled by the chasing bunch. At 70 kilometers, there was a feeding zone, and a group of nine riders took immediate advantage of the running concentration of their opponents. Pastorelli and Canzoneri of Pickford's Removals, Lauren Smith of Mnet Southern Sun, Graham McCullum of Peace for Security, Clinton Curtis, the amateur who had gone so well in the Allied Tour earlier, was there. Mark Bierneke was there, a man who's won the Report Tour previously. From Top Sport VW Fox, two riders were there, Tjern Smulder and Anton Oberholzer. Back in the bunch, Francie Kruger had realized that this was a dangerous move, and by now the Momentum yellow jersey must be terribly heavy on his shoulders. His team tried desperately to contain the escapers, but to no avail. With the team leaders Rob McIntosh and Andrew McLean trapped back in the bunch, Anton Oberholzer and Tjern Smulder defy team tactics to help at the front of the break. Pastorelli and Canzoneri of the Pickford's Removals team also sense the possibility of a stage victory and maybe even overall victory in this year's Momentum Report Tour. In the bunch, two Mnet riders, two VW Fox riders, Graham McCullum and an amateur from the Great British team. The Italians get instructions from their team manager, and who knows what he's saying to them.
En vir die eerste keer vandag word die koopbobas van die berge competitie ook hier beslis en is die tweede premie tydens vandagse skop wat gewen word deur Tjern Smulder, Angelo Canzoneri in die tweede plek en daarna volg Pastorelli. Hulle het baie goed gevaar.
The now fully committed break realizes that they need to make up as much time as possible on the chasing bunch. As it happened earlier to Clinton Curtis, Graham McCullum loses contact with the breakaway group, suffering terribly from cramps, possibly through taking in too few liquids on the stage. Gary Bjørnekke in the chasing group. By now the gap is up to 7 minutes. The Comprehensive Property Services team, the Snowflake Blue Ribbon Squad, and Graham Cockerton from VW Fox Top Sports team chase in vain, knowing that there's no chance of overhauling the leaders. As the riders start jockeying for final positions in the sprint, John Charlesworth of Great Britain knows all he needs to do is finish with the breakaway to take the Momentum yellow jersey from Francie Kruger.
Hier is die naalrit nou, in die strate van Ceres, is Anton Oberholzer, Pastorelli, en aan sy buitenkant is het Mark Bjørnekke. Wie gaan het wees? Bjørnekke en Pastorelli, maar is Pastorelli wat het gemaakt. Pastorelli is daar eerste, die Italianer, en kom ons kyk een slagje weer, baie mooi. Mark Bjørnekke aan die buitenkant, aan die binnenkant is het Pastorelli, Anton Oberholzer in die middel, maar is Pastorelli wat het doen en hy is daar. Die nieuwe draer van die geeltrui is John Charlesworth van die Britse span. 8 secondes voor Anton Oberholzer. In die Liqui Fruit Snel Premies, Crosswhite, Willy Engelbrecht, Kreer en McLean, enige iets kan nog in hierdie afdeling gebeur. Maar kom ons kyk 'n bietjie hoe lyk dinge by die koopbobas van die berge. En dit is net so interessant. Tjern Smulder, apie soos hy bekend staan onder die jaars, kan dalk die ding hier doen. En 'n mens weet nooit wat kan gebeur in hierdie afdeling nie. Ons is môre aand weer saam met u. Dit is Vrydag om 21:30 op TV4, die skof van Wolseley na Belwel, en tot dan, tot ziens.